Members of the NRM Parliamentary Caucus today had a meeting at the office of the Prime Minister where they addressed issues of national importance. According to attendees of the meeting, which was chaired by the Prime Minister Robinah Nabbanja, many concerns of socio-economic transformation were discussed and resolutions were taken to smoothen service delivery.
Today is a historical day because today we have affirmed the request made on the floor of Parliament that every district in Uganda be supported with 1 billion to maintain and rehabilitate our community roads, our and the district roads. This is critical because rehabilitation of our roads is a singular duty that no other private entity can do other than government.
We are charged with the mandate of legislation, of oversight, of appropriation, so we were entirely looking at the budget for the coming financial year and looking at where we were, where we are now and where we want to go as a parliament, as a caucus.
Honorable Julius Karuhanga, the Rampara East legislator, emphasized the need for the NRM top brass to come out and guide members before they are deeply decided by the two camps ahead of the 2026 general elections.
When seeds are supplied through a system of government, one, we shall guarantee quality of the seeds. We have fake seeds on the market. We have had stories where our farmers buy seeds and they cannot grow. So these seeds that government will provide will be gotten from certified production entities, and through the Parliamentary Food Security Livelihood, we pass them on to our communities and we shall be able to enhance productivity at all levels.
However, some NRM lawmakers argued that the succession discussion within the party is far-fetched and not necessary at the time when government is intensifying the 2021 manifesto implementation.
It may be necessary at the right time, but this is not the right time because having traveled a journey of 5 years and you have only used 2 years, I think you should focus on the manifesto implementation, which is very vital because our people there need services. We have to emphasize on the issue of service delivery, on the issue of outstanding presidential pledges. How do we take our people in terms of economic transformation that we have always talked about?
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.